Hello students, today we are going to read second chapter Nelson Mandela, Long Walk to Freedom. First of all, I want to ask a question. Do you know who Nelson Mandela was? Nelson Mandela was a South African anti-apartheid revolutionary who served as president of South Africa from 1994 to 1999. This chapter is an extract from the autobiography of Nelson Mandela titled Long Walk to Freedom. In this extract, Mandela speaks about a historic occasion, the inauguration. It was the occasion when a new democratic government, free from all types of bounds, was going to take over the reign of South Africa under the leadership of Nelson Mandela. For the establishment of this type of government, Mandela had to suffer a lot. He had to spend 27 years in prison for this cause. This chapter throws some light on how he had to undergo difficult situation to seize the monster of apartheid policy in South Africa. First of all, at the very starting of this chapter, we as a reader are introduced by a term apartheid. Apartheid is a political system that separates people according to their race. Apartheid is a system of discrimination on the basis of the race. Here the word race is used for the color of skin. Dark-skinned people in South Africa were deprived of their basic rights. Further, at the starting of this chapter, a short extract from the news item from the BBC of 10th May 1994 is given. In this short extract from the newspaper, the information is given about the inauguration day of Nelson Mandela. Nelson Mandela has become South Africa's first black president after more than three centuries of white rule. Mr. Mandela's African National Congress party won 252 of 400 seats in the first democratic elections of South Africa's history. Because of the apartheid policy in South Africa, Nelson Mandela joined the African National Congress, and on the 27th April 1994, the first democratic election were held in South Africa, and Nelson Mandela's party ANC won by 252 of the 400 seats at that time. The inauguration ceremony took place in the Union Building Amphitheater in Pretoria today, attended by the politicians and dignitaries from more than 140 countries around the world. Never again will this beautiful land experience the oppression of one by another, said Nelson Mandela in his address. The inauguration ceremony was held in the amphitheater, that is in Pretoria. Pretoria is the capital, legislative capital of the South Africa, and on this place many politicians and dignitaries from more than 140 countries were gathered there. And in the address to the public, Nelson Mandela said, "Never ever from that day, not a single person is going to feel the experience of oppression again on by the another person on the soil, on the earth of the South Africa." Further, jubilant scenes on the streets of Pretoria followed the ceremony with blacks, whites and coloureds celebrating together. More than 1 lakh South African men, women and children of all races sang and danced with joy. Now, all the black people of the South Africa got the freedom at that day. That's why more than 1 lakh South African men, women and children were gathered there, and they were enjoying that day. They were singing and dancing with joy. That's why the streets of the Pretoria were seen with the jubilant scenes. Come to the next page. On this page, at the very starting, an activity is given. In this activity, phrases are given in column A, and you have to match the appropriate with the appropriate meaning that is given in the column B. And you have to do this activity by your own self after completion of the reading of this chapter. After this activity, the chapter starts. "10th May, dawned bright and clear. For the past few days, I had been pleasantly besieged by dignitaries and world leaders who were coming to pay their respects before the inauguration. The inauguration would be the largest gathering ever of international leaders on South African soil. The narrator was Nelson Mandela himself, as it is an extract from his autobiography. And he expressed this thing that 10th May, that was the historic day. Nelson Mandela calls this occasion the inauguration. It was the inauguration of the first democratic non-racial government in South Africa, and a huge gathering of international leaders had assembled in Pretoria to mark the end of white supremacy. Here, in the second line, the word besieged by is used. Besieged by means surrounded by. Nelson Mandela was surrounded by many dignitaries and the world leader. Dignitaries means very important and respected people around the world. And they came there to pay their respect towards the Nelson Mandela and to congratulate him on this day. Come to the second paragraph. The ceremonies took place in the lovely sandstone amphitheater formed by the Union Building in Pretoria. For decades, this had been the seat of white supremacy, and now it was the site of a rainbow gathering of different colors and nations for the installation of South Africa's first democratic non-racial government. Here, in this paragraph, Nelson Mandela said that this ceremony took place in the amphitheater that is formed in the Union Buildings in the Pretoria. As I told you, Pretoria is the legislative capital of the South Africa. For decades, this seat, this place of the Pretoria was the seat of the white supremacy. White supremacy means the white people that were in authority. Now it was the site of the rainbow gathering. Here the word rainbow gathering is used. Rainbow gathering means gathering of people from different remote corners of world with intention of living a shared ideology. Ideology of peace, harmony, freedom and respect. And the people from the remote corners of the world gathered there. They were of the different colors. And why they gathered there? They gathered to for the installation of South Africa's first democratic government. Installation means for the establishment of South Africa's first democratic non-racial government. Further, on that lovely autumn day, I was accompanied by my daughter Zanani on the podium. Mr. D. Clark was first sworn in as second deputy president. And here in these lines, Mandela said that Mandela was accompanied by his daughter Zanani. And during the ceremony, Mr. D. Clark was sworn in as a second deputy president. Then come to the next page. Then Thabo Mbeki was sworn in as first deputy president. First of all, Mr. D. Clark was sworn in as second deputy president, and then Mr. Thabo Mbeki, who was sworn in as the first deputy president. When it was my turn, I pledged to obey and uphold the constitution and to devote myself to the well-being of the republic and its people, to the assembled guests and the watching world, I said. Then came the historical moment when Nelson Mandela took the oath as the president of South Africa. He pledged to obey and uphold the constitution and dedicated himself to the well-being of his people. In his public address, Mandela spoke about the newborn liberty, and he said, "Today, all of us do, by our presence here, confer glory and hope to newborn liberty. Out of the experience of an extraordinary human disaster that lasted too long, must be born a society of which all humanity will be proud." In his speech, in the address to the public that was gathered there, Mandela said that today they all present there, and they confer the glory and hope of newborn liberty. They give the glory and hope. They welcome the newborn liberty. And this liberty came out of the extraordinary human disaster. This newborn liberty came from the human disaster. And the phrase human disaster is used for the policy of apartheid that was prevailed before in South Africa. And now this is the birth of a new society. Now all the people and all the humanity will going to be proud on this newborn society. In next paragraph, he said, we who were outlaws not so long ago have today been given the rare privilege to be host to the nations of the world on our soil, on soil. We thank all of our distinguished international guests for having come to take possession with the people of our country of what is after all a common victory for justice, for peace, for human dignity. Now, in his address to the public, he says that we, the we word is used for the public of the people of the South Africa who were outlaws. Outlaws means they were broken of the diplomatic relations from the other countries of the world before, at that time when apartheid policy were there. And now these people were privileged because they have given the chance to host the nation of the world on their own soil. And further, he paid his gratitude to the international guest gathered there to be with his countrymen in the common victory for justice, peace and human dignity. Further, in next paragraph, he said, we have at last achieved our political emancipation. We pledged ourselves to liberate all our people from the continuing bondage of poverty, deprivation, suffering, gender and other discrimination. He said that we achieved political emancipation. Emancipation means freedom. Now they were free from the restrictions, from the limitations. And now they have their own basic rights to live. And Mandela pledged himself to liberate his people from poverty, suffering and discrimination. Further, he said in his address to the public, never, never and never again shall it be that this beautiful land will again experience the oppression of one by another. The sun shall never set on so glorious a human achievement. Let freedom reign. God bless Africa. He expressed his joyful feeling about or for their freedom at that day. And he said that never on this earth of the South Africa, not a single person is going to be oppressed by the another person from that day. The sun was shining very glorious at that day, and that was a human achievement. Now, let freedom reign. Reign is used for the rule. Now, freedom is going to rule the South Africa, and he blessed his own country, South Africa. Come to the next page. Next paragraph. A few moments later, we all lifted our eyes in awe as a spectacular array of South African jets, helicopters and troop carriers rode in perfect formation over the Union buildings. It was not only a display of pinpoint precision and a military force, but a demonstration of the military's loyalty to democracy, to a new government that had been freely and fairly elected only moments before. The highest generals of the South African Defense Force and Policy, their chest bedecked with ribbons and medals from days gone by, saluted me and pledged their loyalty. I was not unmindful of the fact that not so many years before they would not have saluted but arrested me. Finally, a chevron of Impala jets left a smoke trail of the black, red, green, blue and gold of the new South African flag. In this paragraph, Nelson Mandela expressed his observation of the ceremony, and he said that a little while later, a spectacular show by jet defense and police force was presented. Here the word spectacular array is used. Spectacular array means an impressive display, and this display was shown by the police force defense. And South African jets and helicopters flew over the Union buildings. It was not only a display, but a demonstration of the military's loyalty towards the democracy and the new government. This display was not the demonstration by the military force, but this was the symbol of the loyalty of the military towards the democracy and new government that was fairly elected at that time. Further, he said that the chest of the highest general of South African Defence Force and Police was bedecked. Bedecked means decorated. Now, the highest general's chest was decorated with the ribbons and the medals, and they saluted Nelson Mandela and pledged their loyalty towards Nelson Mandela. And he also expressed his feeling that he was aware, not mind. I was not unmindful of. Unmindful of means he was aware of the feeling, aware of the fact that so many years before these highest generals were there, and they would not have saluted at that time, but they arrested him. He recalls his past memories when he was arrested by these highest generals, and on that day, these highest generals were paid their respect towards the Nelson Mandela. Finally, at the end of the show, V-shaped, a chevron of Impala jets. Chevron is a pattern in the shape of a V. And now the V-shaped Impala jets left with a smoke trail of the black, red, green, blue, gold of the new South Africa flag. Come to the next paragraph. The day was symbolized for me by the playing of our two national anthems and the vision of whites singing Nakosi Sikeli, Africa, and blacks singing Die Stem, the old anthem of Republic. Although that day, neither group they knew the lyrics of the anthem they once despised, but they would soon know the words by heart. Further, Nelson Mandela said that that day was symbolized by the playing of their national anthems, and the white people were singing Nelson national anthem as Nakosi Sikeli Africa, and the blacks were singing Die Stem. These are the old anthem of the Republic in South Africa. Although neither group of people, the both the white and the black group, they don't know the lyrics of the anthem because they once despised that anthems. Despised word means they were having a low opinion about those anthems. But he said that they would soon know the words by heart of those national anthems. Come to the next paragraph. On the day of the inauguration, I was overwhelmed with the sense of history. In the first decade of 20th century, a few years later, the bitter Anglo-Boer War, and before my own birth, the white-skinned people of South Africa patched up their differences and erected a system of racial domination against the dark-skinned people of their own land. The structure they created formed the basis of one of the harshest, most inhuman societies the world has ever known. Now, in the last decade of the 20th century and my own eighth decade as a man, that system had been, come to the next page, had been overturned forever and replaced by one that recognized the rights and freedoms of all peoples, regardless of the color of their skin. In this paragraph, Nelson Mandela said that on the day of the inauguration, he was overwhelmed with the sense of history. He was overwhelmed, he was influenced, and he does not forget to recall history on this occasion. He remembers how a system of racial domination was created against the black people in their own land. And he said that in the first decade of the 20th century, a few years after the bitter Anglo-Boer War, Anglo is used for the Britishers and Boer is used for the South African people. And at that time, after the Anglo-Boer War, he said that white-skinned people of the South Africa, the people who were living in South Africa and those were having a white skin, they patch up their differences with the Britishers, and they erected means they raised a system of racial domination against the dark skinned people of their own land. And the white people of the South Africa patched with the Britishers, and they raised this apartheid policy against their people of the dark skin of the South Africa. This structure, this racism was created, and it was the most inhuman system built by the white people in South Africa. Now, he further expressed that now in the last decade of the 20th century and my own 8th decade as a man, it means now last decade of the 20th century, and he was in his age near about the 80, that system of the apartheid policy. Come to the next page. Apartheid policy was overturned for forever, and it is overturned means now it is come to an end. Nelson Mandela feels glad that the cruel system has come to an end, and he promises that in this new system recognition would be given to the rights and freedom of all people regardless of the color of their skin. Come to the next paragraph. That day had come about through the unimaginable sacrifices of thousands of my people, people whose suffering and courage can never be counted or repaid. I felt that day, as I have on so many other days, that I was simply the sum of all those African patriots who had gone before me. That long and noble line ended and now began again with me. I was pained that I was not able to thank them, and that they were not able to see what their sacrifices had wrought. In this paragraph, Mandela also remembers the freedom fighters who sacrificed their life against the oppression, and he said that their freedom fighter sacrifices that is never going to be counted or repaid. And he felt that day that he was simply the one of them from those African patriots. Patriots means a person who loves his country, and he is one of those African patriots. Along with these things, he said that he was feeling very much sorrowful on that day because he was not able to thank to those freedom fighters because they were not present there. And along with this thing, they were not present there to see that day and to see what they have achieved by their sacrifices. The word wrought is used. Wrought means the achievement, what their sacrifices achieved. Now he pays his respect, he pays his gratitude toward those freedom fighters, and he said that that freedom is possible because of those freedom fighters, and he was one of them. Come to the next paragraph. The policy of apartheid created a deep and lasting wound in my country and my people. All of us will spend many years, if not generation, recovering from that profound hurt, but the decades of oppression and brutality had another unintended effect, that was that it produced the Oliver Tambos, the Walter Sisulus, the Chief Lithulis, and the Yusuf Dadus, the Bram Fisheries, the Robert Subukwis of our time, men of such extraordinary courage. In this paragraph, Nelson Mandela says that the policy of the apartheid created a very deep and lasting wounds in the heart of the country people, in the heart of the people of the South Africa, and they spent many years in this torment, and many a generation is never going to be able to recover that profound hurt from their mind. But the decades of these oppression and brutality raises such type of brave leaders like Oliver Tambos, Walter Sisulus, and Chief Lutalis, and Yusuf Dadus, the Bram Fisheries, and the Robert Subukwis of Nelson Mandela's time. And they were the men of the extraordinary courage. Come to the next page. They were the men of the extraordinary courage, wisdom, and generosity. that their like may never be known again. All these freedom fighters are the men of extraordinary courage, wisdom, and generosity. They were full of bravery and witness. Perhaps it requires such a depth of oppression to create such heights of character. My country is rich in minerals and gems that lie beneath its soil, but I have always known that its greatest wealth is its people, finer and truer than the purest diamond. Now, further, Nelson Mandela said that for such type of a great characters like these leaders, freedom, like these freedom fighters, it required depth of oppression. And out of these oppression, such type of a great characters raised, such type of a great characters born. And further, he said that his country, it means South Africa, is rich in minerals and gems that lie beneath its soil, beneath the soil of the South Africa. But the real wealth, the greatest wealth of South Africa is its people, that is more finer and truer than the purest diamonds. He said that the people of the South Africa were the great wealth of the South Africa than the purest diamonds. Come to the next paragraph. It is from these comrades in the struggle that I learned the meaning of courage time and again. I have seen men and women risk and give their lives for an idea. I have seen men stand up to attacks and torture without breaking, showing a strength and resilience that defies the imagination. I learned that courage was not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. The brave man is not he who does not feel afraid, but he who conquered that fear. Further, in these lines, he said that these comrades taught him the meaning of the courage. These comrades, these freedom fighters, teach him a real bravery. And time and again, he had seen men and women, those risk their lives for an idea. Here the word idea is used for freedom, that many men and women at that time risk their lives for the freedom. Most of the men stand up to attacks and the torture. Men at that time, they faces many attacks and the torture without breaking themselves, and they show a lot of strength and resilience. The word resilience means ability to deal the hardship and to recover from the bad time, and that defies the imagination. Defies means to refuse. And many men and women at that time, those who feel the who face the attacks and the torture, and they show their strength at that time, and they show their hardship, and they recover from those torments, and they refused to obey the imagination, to obey the apartheid policy. Further, he said that he learned the courage was not the absence of fear. He just want to say that courage is further he said that courage was not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it, fear. The brave man is not the one who does not fear, but the one who conquer it. The word conquer means who won it. The brave man is not the person who feel afraid of anything or of any person, but the person who overcome that fear that is inside him. Come to the next paragraph. No one is born hating another person because of the color of his skin or his background or his religion. People must learn to hate, and if they can learn to hate, they can be taught to love, for love comes more naturally to the human heart than its opposite. Even in the grimmest time in prison, when my comrades and I were pushed to our limits, I would see a glimmer of humanity in one of the guards, perhaps just for a second, but it was enough to reassure me and keep me going. Man's goodness is a flame that can be hidden but never extinguished. In these lines, Nelson Mandela said that no person is born with the feeling of the hatred, hatred for the skin, hatred for the background, hatred for the religion. And at the time of the birth, no person know the discrimination and the feeling of the hatred. And people must learn to hate. And after, when they grow up, they learn the feeling of the hate. And if they are able to learn the feeling of the hate, they can also be taught about love, about the emotion of love, because love is the emotion which comes to man naturally. If we learn to hate, we can learn to love also. It is love that comes naturally to the human heart. This is what we should follow nature and should learn to love. For this, he just gave an example and he said that even in the grimmest times in the prison, grimmest time even is the most torture time when he was in the prison. And he and his comrades here is used for the his fellow members, they were pushed to their limit. Pushed to their limits means that they were punished and they were tortured out of the limits. And all of them, they tolerate all those things. At that time, he observed a guard that was standing there. And he saw a glimmer of humanity. A glimmer of it means he saw a brightness of the humanity on the face of that guard. And he find out that this brightness of the humanity was enough to reassure him that humanity was alive, that love and the goodness was alive in the human beings. And further, he said that man's goodness is a flame that can be hidden but never extinguished. And he want to say that man's goodness is just like a flame of a fire that can be hidden, that the goodness in a man, we may hide that goodness in ourselves, but it never going to be end in a human person. Extinguish means come to an end. Further, in next paragraph, he said, in life, every man has twin obligation to his family, to his parents, to his wife and children. And he has an obligation to his people, his community, his country. Here in these lines, Nelson Mandela is talking about the obligation. Obligation is used for the responsibility. Every man in this world is having two type of responsibility. Twin means two type. And obligation means responsibility. And one, the responsibility and the, we can say, obligation towards his family members, and the other type of obligation is towards his people, community and the country. Further, in a civil and human, come to the next page. In a civil and a human society, each man is able to fulfill those obligations according to his own inclination and abilities. But in a country like South Africa, it was almost impossible for a man of my birth and color to fulfill both of those obligations. In South Africa, a man of color who attempted to live as a human being was punished and isolated. In South Africa, a man who tried to fulfill his duty to his people was inevitably ripped from his family and his home and was forced to live a life apart, a twilight existence of secrecy and rebellion. I did not in the beginning choose to place my people above my family, but in attempting to serve my people, I found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligation as a son, a brother, a father, and a husband. In these lines, Nelson Mandela describes the twin obligation, the one obligation towards his family, and the second one is towards his people, community, and country. And he says that each man is able to fulfill these a twin obligation according to his inclination and according to his abilities. Inclination means natural tendencies of the behavior, and abilities means skill. A person can fulfill these two types of responsibilities according to his behavior and skill. But a person who is living in South Africa And for that person, it was almost impossible for the persons of the South Africa, Africa and the black people, just like Nelson Mandela, to fulfill the obligation. Because if a black people is just wanted to live like a human being, and he just wanted to fulfill his duty towards the people and towards the family, he was punished and isolated by the white supremacy at that time. And his people was inevitably ripped from his family. It means inevitably means unavoidably. Ripped from, it means separated from the family. If a person is going to try to fulfill his duty towards his family and towards his people, he was just separated from his family home and he was forced to live alone. And in the, he was forced to live like a rebellion and like a secret life. And further, he said that for at first he did not choose country over his family, but after later on he devoted his life to the freedom of his people from slavery. And he found that he was prevented from fulfilling the responsibilities as a son, brother and father and a husband, because he just wanted to serve his country people. He just wanted his country people to free from this apartheid policy. Come to the next paragraph. I was not born with a hunger to be free. I was born free. Free in every way that I could know, free to run in the fields near my mother's hut, free to swim in the clear stream that ran through my village, free to roast meals under the stars and ride the broad backs of slow-moving bulls. As long as I obeyed my father and abided by the customs of my tribe, I was not troubled by the laws of men or God. In this paragraph, he just expressed the freedom in two ways. First of all, he expressed his freedom as a grown-up child, and he said that at that time freedom for him is to run in the fields near his mother's house, freedom to swim in the clear stream, in the clear river, and freedom to run through the village, and freedom to cook meals under the stars. Here roast meals means to cook meals. Ride, and freedom to ride the broad backs of the slow moving bulls. All these things is included in the freedom as a grown up child. But he said that as long as he was living with his father and he was living under the custom of his tribe, he was not influenced or troubled by the laws that was created by the man or God. He was living very much free when he was living in his tribe and he was living with his father. Come to the next paragraph. It was only when I began to learn that my boyhood freedom was an illusion, when I discovered as a young man that my freedom had already been taken from me, that I began to hunger for it. At first, as a student, I wanted freedom only for myself, the transitory freedom of being able to stay out at night, read what I pleased, and go where I chose. Later, as a young man in Johannesburg, I yearned for the basic and the honorable freedoms of achieving my potential, of earning my keep, of marrying and having a family, the freedom not to be obstructed in a lawful life. In this paragraph, Nelson Mandela expressed that when he grew up as a student and he realized that the boyhood, the childhood freedom was only an illusion. Only a illusion is here used for the imagination, that it was only a fancy. And he realized that when he discovered as a young man, as a student, and his freedom had already been taken from him. As a young man, he realized that his freedom was already taken from him. At first, he expressed his feeling as a student. He said that when I was a student, he wanted freedom for his own self. That was the transitory freedom. And he says that as a student, he just want freedom to stay out at night, and he just want freedom to read what he just want to read that pleases him, and to go where he want to choose. And later, as a young man, later as a mature man in the Johannesburg, and he realized that he yearned for the basic and honorable freedoms. Yearned means he desire for the basic and honorable freedom of achieving his potential of earning his keep. It means the basic and honorable freedom were the freedom for the people to live their lives with dignity and self-respect. As a mature man, he realized this thing. Come to the next paragraph. But then I slowly saw that not only was I not free, but my brother and sisters were not free. I saw that it was not just my freedom that was curtailed, but the freedom of everyone who looked like I did. That is when I joined the African National Congress, and that is when the hunger for my own freedom became the greater hunger for the freedom. In these lines, Nelson Mandela expressed that when he grew up and slowly he realized that he was not the only person whose freedom was curtailed. Curtailed means reduced. In literal sense, curtail means to cut. Here means to reduce and taken away. He was not only a person whose freedom was taken away from him, but his brother and sister in South Africa, everyone was deprived of their freedom. And just after that, he joined the African National Congress, and he feel the hunger for the freedom for his own self, but the hunger for the freedom. Come to the next page. The hunger for the freedom of his people, or his people means the people of the South Africa. And he says that at that time when he joined the National Congress, South African Congress Party, at that time he realized that he feels a hunger for freedom for his own self, but the hunger of for the freedom of his country people was greater than the that freedom that he wants for himself. Further, he says that it was this desire for the freedom of my people to live their lives with dignity and self-respect that animated my life, that transformed a frightened young man into a bold one, that drove a law-abiding attorney to become a criminal, that turned a family-loving husband into a man without a home, that forced a life-loving man to live like a monk. I am no more virtuous or self-sacrificing than the next man, but I found that I could not even enjoy the poor and limited freedom I was allowed when I knew my people were not free. Freedom is indivisible. The chains on any one of my people were the chains on all of them. The chains on all of my people were the chains on me. In these lines, Nelson Mandela expressed the thing that this desire for the freedom of his country people is the desire with the dignity and self-respect, and this desire animated his life. Animated means totally changed his life, and his life was transformed. This desire transformed him into a bold one. Before this desire, he said that I was a frightened young man, but now I am a bold man, and this desire changed me as a criminal, because before this I was a lawful person, but now I am a rebellion. That's why I am a criminal. That and this desire of the freedom of his country people make him a person without a home, a person to live like a monk, because he was separated from his family and he lived his life just like a monk. That is why. And he says that I am a no more virtuous or self-sacrificing person. No. He said that I am no more virtuous and self-sacrificing than to the next other persons that were living in South Africa. But he feels very much. He said that I am no more virtuous and self-sacrificing, but I can't enjoy the poor or limited freedom when I know that the other people of my country were not free. Freedom, according to the Nelson Mandela, freedom is indivisible. Indivisible means freedom can't be divided into parts. And he expressed that the chains of any one of my people were the chains on all of them. If here the word chains is used for the restrictions, for the limitations, for the feeling, the hatred feeling. And he said that the chains of any one of my people were the chains of all of them. If a single person is in the restriction, it means the whole humanity, the whole people of the South Africa, all the people of South Africa were in the restriction. And when all the people of South Africa in the restriction, he himself was in the restriction. That's why he feels that if another person's freedom is taken away, his own freedom was taken away from him. Further, in next paragraph, he said that I knew that the oppressor must be liberated just as surely as the oppressed. A man who takes away another man's freedom is a prisoner of hatred. He is locked behind the bars of prejudice and narrow-mindedness. I am not truly free if I am taking away someone else's freedom, just as surely as I am not free when my freedom is taken from me. The oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of their humanity. Now, in this paragraph, Nelson Mandela expresses the person as a oppressor and the person as a oppressed. And he says that both the oppressor and the oppressed need to be liberated, one from the chains of the hatred and the other from the chains of the body. Because a person who have the feeling of the hatred is in the prison of the prejudice and the narrow-mindedness. Prejudice means a feeling of dislike and hatred towards the other persons. And he said that if I am going to snatch someone else's freedom, it means I am the prisoner of my own narrow-mindedness and I am the prisoner of my own feeling of the hatred. And he said that the oppressor and the oppressed both are same and they both are robbed of. Robbed of means they both are in the same situation and the freedom the freedom of both oppressor and oppressed is taken away from them. Both are robbed of their humanity. With this, the chapter that is the autobiography of Nelson Mandela completed. And that's all for today. Hope you understand this chapter. Thank you. Have a nice day.